my channel. It's a very simple vegetarian recipe, but it's a favorite with everyone. At least all of us in our place, everybody loves it. And it's a paneer chili recipe. And I'm trying to show it to you as we make it at home. Because everybody in our house likes it, I thought you might also like it. So let me introduce you the ingredients. I have taken here around 150 grams of paneer, but I have just made huge slices of the paneer like this, as long as possible, and I've tried to keep it long this way. Okay, you may keep it diced and cubed if you want, but I like it this way when I'm talking about paneer, chili paneer. And I've taken here around half a capsicum and given this size there. I've cut into this shape. The internal portion has been removed totally, and you just have this crust there. I have taken one big onion and the same shape. I've tried to give the same shape like this, just the same shape of the capsicum as well as the onion. I have taken here some spring onion, and this is the white part of the spring onion, and this is the green part. So we have around one small bowl of each. I will need around 3 big tablespoons of maida or refined flour, 2 big tablespoons of corn flour, around 15 pods of garlic diced into small pieces, 1 inch of ginger made smashed and diced into small pieces, and some basic ingredients which are necessary, like the chili sauce and the soy sauce. And the entire cooking will be done in any vegetable oil of your choice. I have used canola oil here. I will of course need some salt. So let's start cooking this very special dish. In fact, something that's so easy, you can make it anytime and still enjoy it every time you make it. So let's first, what I do is that I'm going to do something like marinate the cubes of paneer. For that, I'm going to throw in the corn flour and just some, this is the salt there. So we'll give it a mix and let it stay like this for some time. And because of this coating, it will be very crisp now. Okay, the next thing I do is that take another bowl and throw in the maida. Okay, and some salt. Just a required amount of salt, not much. And make a batter out of it using some water. I'm also adding 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. You know, that will make it crispier. And let me make now a little batter there, but not very watery, just the amount that will stick to the pieces of paneer. So I'm just making a batter out of it, and this is what I'm going to dip into. I may add a little bit of soy sauce here, but you may avoid it also. Meanwhile, I have taken heated up 2 pans. On one pan, just a small teaspoon of oil I've put in. On the other pan, I'm going to put in, say, 1.5 tablespoons of oil there. So let both the pans heat up, and we're going to work together. This will make your life much easier and faster. In the first pan there, I'm putting in the pieces of capsicum. I'm going to fry the roots on high flame. Normally I do the Chinese cooking on high flame. That way you have everything ready and you do it. So let it be there. Then it changes the color there. See there, it's done. And I can remove it. Very, very lightly I fry it and I remove it. Okay. So that's done. Next thing I put in, this is the onion. Onion goes in. I have used very less oil, as you can see, because I'm also going to use the oil that I'm using to fry my pieces of paneer. So here I'm using very, very less oil, and I'm also putting in the ginger garlic there. And on very slow flame now, I let it cook. I'm trying to be a little healthy, as you can see that. So let it cook for some time. Let me attend here. And now what I do is that I am going to dip the pieces of paneer and then throw into the plate and give them a nice fry there. So So this way I'll repeat for all of you. Now this is a very very easy peasy recipe, but something everybody likes. So you can all try it out one day at least. Meanwhile, let me give a stir here. Okay, and the white part also goes in. And we're giving it a try there, and let it be there like this. I don't want to be completely mashed. I just want it to be little fried. Meanwhile, we'll try and turn them over. See that beautiful color that you have? This is what I want there. Even for this. So this way, I'll fry all my pieces of paneer. So I'm throwing in next is the, say one small, 1.5 teaspoons of soy sauce and just a small teaspoon of green chili sauce. Give it a nice mix there, and now I'm going to throw in the water. The water goes in. I'm giving a little water, so I want all of that to cook properly. And I'm also throwing the fried pieces of capsicum. Increase the heat a bit and let it boil while I fry up the pieces of paneer. While this is boiling up, I'll also put in the remaining green, this is the spring onion there, and give it a mix again. So we don't want it very watery, we just want a little gravy there. So now I'm going to throw in all the fried pieces of paneer. They all go in, and again it'll boil for some time, and then we'll go check in for the salt. I'm adding the amount of salt this is necessary. Add in some pepper and let it simmer for some time, and then the slurry of the corn flour will go in and it'll be done. So let it be cooking for some time on slow flame. The paneer pieces soak in the flavors that are in the pan. I'm adding in a little bit of soy sauce for the beautiful color there. And then giving it a turn, just turning it around, and then we're making a slurry of corn flour in water. And the moment I put in, it'll be like magic. Everything will thicken up and be ready. So that is it. My chili paneer ready in minutes. So that's ready. My chili paneer. Very simple and yet very, very delicious. I hope you'll give it a try. I'll hope you'll give it a like and a thumbs up. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Thank you so much for watching.